Custom Components enables developers to bring any React component into Superblocks applications seamlessly. Front-end developers can bring any components from the web or their organization's codebase into Superblocks in minutes. Then, Superblocks developers can leverage these components via a drag-and-drop interface, like any native Superblocks component. This is our insurance claim processing support hub. I have a bunch of open tickets from our customers that we're pulling in from the internal API we use to manage our customers. Peter has reached out to us, opening a new claim by mailing us a letter. Currently, our process requires this file to be converted to a PDF outside of Superblocks before a support agent is able to process it. Using Superblocks custom components, we've created a component to capture images via our webcam and scan them directly into this application. To get started with Superblocks custom components, all I'll need to do is install the Superblocks CLI. I'll install the CLI from my terminal using npm. Once installed, I'll log into my account. I'll create a new directory to manage my Superblocks resources and navigate into it. I'll initialize my application directory locally using the URL from my application. Once this is complete, I'll navigate into my application directory and create a new component using the Superblocks CLI, configuring a name for our component. Next, we'll set an image property that we'll use to store our captured image. Properties comprise the state of the component and can be made readable and settable by other parts of an application. They can also be exposed via the properties panel in the Superblocks editor, so that Superblocks developers can set their values when dragging them onto the app canvas. Since we'll set this property when we capture the image, and it doesn't need to be set when dragging the component on screen, I'll hide it from the properties panel. I'll add an additional Boolean property that I'll use to style our application later on, called confetti. I will expose this property in the properties panel. I'll also create an event for on-image capture. We'll use this event to notify the rest of our Superblocks application when an image is captured, and we can set up event handlers in the properties panel to trigger any series of actions. This command generates a directory for my component, which includes a few key files. The component.typescript contains the React code for my component. The config.typescript contains the configuration which was generated using my response in the wizard. The types.ts file contains automatically generated TypeScript types. It'll be regenerated each time I update my config.ts file while running the watch command, so my types remain current as I develop. As you can see, I have strong TypeScript support across this project, which makes development more intuitive and safer. In order to develop your component, you'll use Superblocks Local Development Mode. This mode allows you to serve the component from your local machine and interact with it in the Superblocks UI. I'll run the watch command to run a local development server, clicking the link returned by the command to open my application with local dev mode enabled. When local development mode is enabled, the application fetches the component from your development server running on your local machine. Local dev mode provides hot reloading, so when you edit your component locally, the change is immediately reflected in Superblocks. I'll open up the properties panel to see my exposed confetti property and on-image change event handler. For this component, I want to take advantage of the existing ecosystem of React components that are already out there. I'm going to use some libraries from the web, but I could easily leverage existing components from my company's internal component library. I'll start by installing React Webcam, React Confetti, and the AntD design library. I'll update my components.typescript to import these libraries and replace the provided React command with this new webcam component and a button to create a screenshot. I'll also create the handler function that's triggered by my button's onClick event in my React code. This function will use the update properties method, which I obtained using the use Superblocks context hook, to set our image property to the base64 string returned by our webcam library. I'll additionally fire off our onImageUpdate event in this function. So this event is triggered in Superblocks when the user clicks the capture button. When I hit save, the Superblocks application will refresh to showcase my updated component. In the properties panel, I'll add an API that'll get triggered to return our image value so we can see our captured base64 string. We can style this component using a variety of styling approaches, including CSS modules, CSS and JavaScript libraries like Tailwind CSS, and more. As we previously installed the Ant Design library, I'll update my button to utilize the built-in button from Ant Design. I'll also add the confetti component from the React Confetti library to my return TypeScript. As Superblocks provides full DOM control, I'm able to render the confetti outside of the boundaries of our custom component on the app canvas using a full-screen React portal. I'll add some logic to conditionally display this confetti only when the confetti property is enabled, so that developers can control this behavior via the properties panel. I'll save, allowing our app to hot reload and capture a new image. To finalize this application, I want to be able to share it with my coworkers and enable it to run outside of local dev. I'll upload my component from the CLI. Once complete, I'll disable local dev mode to confirm everything functions as expected. Now that I'm out of local dev mode, the component will be served from the Superblocks CDN instead of my local dev server. Now that the component is uploaded, any other developer in Superblocks can use it as they would any built-in Superblocks component without ever touching React. Since my component is ready for use, I'll commit my application. Each time I create a commit, the version of the custom component uploaded at the time of the commit is pinned to that commit. This versioning ensures that custom components are versioned alongside your commits. With custom components, Superblocks gives you the full extensibility of React when building internal tooling. In moments, you can bring any component from the web or an internal codebase into Superblocks and leverage them via drag and drop like any native Superblocks component.